In the early 20th century, transportation was one of the weaker aspects of China's economy. In 1936, the total length of railways in the United States was 30 times that of China. And in 1940, America's system of highways was 40 times longer than China's. Let's now first focus on the railways. When New China was founded in 1949, the total length of its railway network in operation was just under 22,000 kilometers, much of which was very old. In 1978, with the country's reform and opening up again, it had more than doubled to 52,000 kilometers. By 2018, the increase on 1949 was sixfold. However, Chinese rail made a significant breakthrough in 2008 when it opened its first high-speed line. The network has slowly grown to cover nearly all major cities, with its total length in 2018 at 29,000 kilometers. To put that into context, it's 60% of the world's total, and the government is looking to build on it further. A 2016 national plan extended it from the original 4+4 structure into an 8+8. What that essentially means is that by 2030, there should be 8 horizontal and 8 vertical high-speed corridors. By 2035, China's entire rail network is expected to reach 200,000 kilometers, with a high-speed network doubling to 70,000 kilometers. Now to roads. Between 1949 and 1978, China's system of highways increased 11-fold. By the end of 2018, it had expanded 60 times on 1949 and ranked first in the world. And although there were virtually no expressways on the Chinese mainland until 1988, 30 years later, it had the world's longest network at 143,000 kilometers. Ambitious transport plans for the future. China will hope its latest 5-year plan for economic and social development can go a long way to achieving them. In that plan, the government hopes to add 3,000 kilometers of rail and build 30 new airports in 3 years.